take off the brake caliper by removing the Allen screw. And then we're going to remove the pin with the starter punch caulking now. We've already removed the brake caliper so that you can see on this presentation. Second, we take off the nuts that hold the axle in place, and then remove the axle. Okay, so now we're going to take off the jam nut. We're going to take off the locking nut on the inside. Last, we have to take off the adjusting nut. And it helps too if you set these all up in order, so that way you know which order they went on. Outer bearing and set that with the nut assembly. Then we're going to take off the belt. Set it in this.
Yes.
Now we take this, we're going to set this right in the oil pan. Okay, now we're gonna take off the seal.
Be careful not to bend it.
And we're gonna take out the inner bearing.
Okay.
Now we're gonna take these over to the cleaning tank and we're gonna get them all cleaned up. Okay, now we're gonna clean them off a little bit. We're just gonna show you how to do that a little bit. Now we gotta dry them all out with the air hose. Get them all ready to oil. And make sure that they're all lubricated. Get all the bearings lubricated. When we're done, we take them back over to the truck. Okay, now we already put the oil seal and the inner bearing in, so now we're going to use the seal driver and put it together. Okay, now we gotta put the hub back on. Careful not to catch it up on the
seal. He's gonna be shitting blood on him.
Okay, now we gotta put on the inner bearing. Make sure you look at the wheel. Okay, now we got that in. Now we gotta torque this. We gotta torque the adjusting nut down to 200 foot-pounds. And there we go. Okay, And now we gotta take it off one full turn. So bring it halfway. There we go. And now we need to torque it down to 50 foot-pounds after we've taken it off one full turn. Make sure you're rotating the wheel when you're doing this. And now we gotta back it off one quarter turn. Now it's been loosened one quarter turn because we measured it all out and that's what it said it had to be loosened. Okay, now I need to make sure we need to establish end plate has to be in between 1 to 5 thousandths. And this one just makes it. So this one's good. Okay, now we need to tighten down the jam nut to the specifications. Got it. Okay, now we got the jam nut in place. And it's just right. It's between 1 thousandths to 5 thousandths. So it's just in the range we need. So we're good with that step. Now we have to put in the axle and then put the nuts back on and we're done.